So I'm actually pretty freaking excited. This week has been a big week for me, kind of an epiphany struck me. You see, those who have followed my videos or my writings for a while know that for me, sales is about a lot of components. You have to learn prospecting and qualification and closing. But the most important aspect of sales is this thing that I call discovery, right? Uncovering, not just, you know, learning about what somebody needs, what they're trying to accomplish, but really helping them dig and discover, you know, deeper levels of understanding. For 15, maybe 20 years, I've been teaching the process of discovery, and I've been very passionate about it. And I've always taught it from a conceptual framework. You know, here's how you do it. Here's the philosophy. Here's where you have to be coming from. And what has eluded me is the ability to really convey to folks what I like to refer to as the exactly how, right? So for me, I think the most powerful way to teach and coach people is not just to give them concepts, but the exactly how they should do something. And, you know, quite frankly, I haven't been able to do much of that in the area of discovery, like I said, for the last, you know, 15, 20 years. I've put out some, you know, questions and other specific things to ask, but in terms of this is the process you follow for discovery, it's been elusive. And what I actually attribute, you know, in part to this epiphany is I've been working with a lot of younger, fairly inexperienced sales teams, you know, a lot of folks that people like to call millennials. And fundamentally, working with these folks, there was a lot of resistance I had initially. And you know, they're not willing to put in their dues, they're you know, they think they know everything or whatever people say about them. But what I found is working with these very, very intelligent, very bright, very passionate, you know, inexperienced and younger sales folks, is that they have a very, very strong desire to learn and to do well and to accomplish things. And you know, they want to get to where they want to be, you know, much faster than, oh, I'll just figure this out over 10 years. So they really push back on this notion of, well, you'll know it when you see it, or you just have to figure it out. And, you know, so I'd be working with these folks and coaching them. And I was very good at teaching them or talking to them about what they, you know, should be doing conceptually. And then in terms of specifics, I could say, well, don't do that and don't do that. But I couldn't say, this is exactly how you do the process. And that's something, like I said, I'm really passionate about. I really want people to walk away from working with me with a very specific toolkit, a very specific process that they can go implement to be successful. So this caused me a lot of frustration, but, you know, working with these folks and kind of coming back again and again with folks who really didn't accept, well, you know, you'll know in 10 years or in 5 years you'll get it, had a major breakthrough this week. And I'll give you the highlights, and then, you know, basically I'll be releasing a series of articles and some process docs around that. But fundamentally, what I've come to understand is that in the process of discovery, right, there is an interaction you're having with your prospect, right? There's the two of you. And the word you'll hear me use a lot in this whole series is interface points, right? Interface, you know, is the distance between any two components of a system. So I have an interface point with my prospect. The challenge in the discovery process is if I'm trying to probe and really understand my prospect directly in the interface point between us, I've got two challenges. One is I'm going to experience resistance because naturally people, you know, don't just sort of open up and share their hopes and their dreams and their pain and their aspirations and what they want, you know, just naturally with somebody they've just met. So there's kind of a trust and a relationship factor. The second challenge that I found with respect to effectiveness in this you know, primary interface point is the fact that most people don't walk into work every day, you know, in this hyper self-reflective mode. They haven't been up all night thinking about, you know, what they want for their life, you know, what does better look like. So we start asking all these questions and they very quickly run out of rope, right? We run out of any real depth that they can accommodate in the conversation. So there's only so much I can ask you about you on the first conversation that's going to actually, you know, yield any real information. Yet that's what we've been trained, you know, go in and engage with a prospect and ask them all these probing questions and, you know, try to understand their world. Well, what I've come upon is this idea that the primary interface point, that between you and the prospect, is actually far less, important is not the right word, but will bear far less fruit than focusing on two other interface points that not only provide a greater level of comfort for the prospect, but also have the potential to reveal a greater level of insight and truth. So the first interface point that I want to talk about to focus on is the interface point between your prospect and their company. So I came up with a whole list of questions. You know, tell me about your job. Tell me about what you're responsible for producing for your company, delivering. What are the initiatives that you're working on? Who assigned you those initiatives? There are all these questions I can ask you, and I just like you to think visually that I'm asking about what's happening behind you, all the people you're interacting with. And that becomes a very powerful means to understand that person's role in the organization, where they fit, how they're compensated, you know, what they represent to you as truth. It helps you calibrate that down the line, right? So one of the things you got to realize is that there's no absolute truth. Somebody says, oh, you know, we're going to go this direction, or this is a top priority for the company. Well, that's their statement of opinion, right? It's only one data point in the equation. So to actually get to the truth in any organization, I've got to be able to triangulate, you know, what you're telling me, you know, across multiple viewpoints. The most simple way to think about this is typically I will, you know, take a line level or a functional decision maker, and I will triangulate what they tell me with an executive decision maker, right? I'm getting at least a couple data points. The second interface point is the interface between the company and the customer, right? And I can certainly talk to my prospect about, you know, their customers. Tell me about who your customers are. Who's an ideal customer? What do they pay you to do for them? What does what you do for them, you know, deliver for them? Who are your customers' customers? What is the financial relationship with your customers? After you consummate a deal with them, what happens? How do you deliver your services? You know, how does that usually work? How do you know if it's working? How do you know if the customer's happy? Once your services have been delivered or implemented or whatever it is, and they've paid you, what relationships do you have with your customers on an ongoing basis, right? So see, there's all this real richness that frankly gets at some very important, very intimate information, but does so in a way that frankly seems very natural and obvious in a business context, right? So all this entire topic is about how to do discovery better, and really it's how to enter into the process of discovery. Once I have a bunch of data points, I can dig deeper on each of those, but you know, the challenge for most of us is really just starting. How do I get into the conversation and get the person talking, not about their specific pain that my product's going to solve, but everything that I need to know holistically about them and their company and how they make decisions, all the things that are going to be required for the sale. Focusing on these two interface points is really the key to that. So below you'll see basically a link for a download with some specific questions. And keep an eye out for some additional videos. I'm going to be going into this process some more and showing some more details and getting more technical about it. But I just wanted to shoot this video kind of quick and let you see what I was up to.